As you may have guessed by now, Jordan Maxwell is not this man's real name. And I don't have any kind of problem with that. Using a pseudonym is a perfectly reasonable and understandable practice. But there is something a little fishy with the name that Jordan Maxwell chose. Here's why. In Madame Helena Petrovna Blavatsky's book, Isis Unveiled, Volume 2, Theology, she tells us what her version of the Nazarene Trinity is. And she tells us that the second in the Trinity is Jordanus Maximus. It is said that Jordanus Maximus, the water of life, he is the one through whom we alone can be saved.
Gentlemen, have you ever heard or read Mrs. Blavatska? She's...
Helena Petrovna Blavatsky?
Right.
Yes. Yes, I have all of her works.
You have?
Yes.
Well, that's why... Yes.
I think her best work was Isis Unveiled, Part 2, which is theology.
Right. Science.
And that was an exceptional work. I think that Helena Petrovna Blavatsky, the Russian mystic, was a very wise and perceptive lady, and she had some very profound knowledge, obviously, and her academic achievements were extraordinary, and so I have a very high respect for the work of Helena Blavatsky.
So are we really to believe that Jordan Maxwell had no previous knowledge of the term Jordanus Maximus, the second in the Trinity of Helena Blavatsky, in her book Isis Unveiled, Volume 2, Theology, which he clearly says is his favorite book? This man, claiming to be a great wordsmith, didn't know that until he got an email from a rabbi? Something doesn't add up. Jordan Maxwell is quite matter-of-factly telling us that the real meaning of the Jewish Ark of the Covenant is not what the Jewish people wrote about extensively, but instead what Helena Blavatsky said in her book, The Secret Doctrine. Some scholars suggest that the entire Bible is about what the Ark of the Covenant represents. But all parties do agree that, according to the Hebrews, it did not represent the female ability to give life. This version is only found in Freemasonry. It is also very suspicious why Maxwell continually tells us that true history is the mystery school history.
And so the priest would drop blood in front of the ark, representing the menstrual cycle of the female.
This is really funny if you think about it. Jordan Maxwell is secretly using Helena Blavatsky's version of Judaism as his source to discredit Judaism. To say that's a biased source would be an understatement. Madame Blavatsky's writings were said to influence Hitler and therefore the Nazi regime. So to have this anti-Jewish rhetoric being said to be true history is concerning, and it should be a red flag to the truth movement, in my opinion. And the Osiris cycle of death and resurrecting. It is this tradition that is played out in Skull and Bones of the laying in the coffin and being reborn. That's why George Bush can say that he is born again when people ask him if he's a Christian. It all goes back to the ancient mystery schools of Egypt, and the initiates, all initiates, would lay into the sarcophagus of the Great Pyramid of Giza to be reborn into the mystery school tradition. Oddly, Maxwell has done that.
If you've never been in the Great Pyramid of Giza, I will tell you it's an extraordinary experience. I laid in the king's sarcophagus and was blessed in a ritual by a Kemite priest.
The fact of the matter is, joy comes from that bliss of connectedness. That's our God spirit. That's that side of ourselves that really feels it. You can feel it deep inside you. It's this amazing, wonderful feeling. And you know it when you get it. You don't get it from money. You get it from connection.
In part one of the film Zeitgeist, nearly 200 sources are cited in the transcript. Yet many of these sources are used more than once. For example, Manly P. Hall is cited 5 times. Albert Churchwood is cited 6 times. Timothy Freak and Peter Gandy are cited 7 times. Edward Carpenter is cited 8 times. Thomas Doane cited 19 times. D.M. Murdoch is cited 2x. However, D.M. Murdoch also goes by the pen name Acharya S. Acharya S. is cited an additional 27, and Gerald Massey is cited 30 times. In fact, when the transcript for this film is examined in further detail, we see that less than 25% of these sources are original. The idea that Jesus is a copycat solar deity has been propagated by the self-taught Egyptologist and practicing Druid Gerald Massey, homosexual activist and philosopher Edward Carpenter, atheist professor John Allegro, and authors Peter Gandy and Timothy Freak, and Acharya S.
mean, we've shown time and time again that all the Vatican is a continuation of the Roman religion. They turned their many pantheon of gods into the saints, and they turned their top goddess into Mary. But the common enemy of Rome and the hybrid Christian slash pagan Catholic Church was always real Christians, people that really believed in the Bible and really believed in Jesus Christ. Those people were the enemy of both Rome and the Catholic Church.